Smart Wargames here, let's continue the Kampfgruppe Engel campaign. Yeah, we were stripped of some tanks. Could be because they were damaged and needed to be go into maintenance. But I still have confidence we will manage. And this mission will become a special one. We looks like we need to retrieve a King Tiger, which then might push turret. I think. Didn't see that one often. Porsche turret was that one that didn't went into mass production, right? I'm not a certified King Tiger expert, but I will not remember seeing this Porsche tech here, so but it's a B. It looks like a King Tiger. But we will retrieve it. But first check the briefing, what is going on here. Yeah, the campaigns that give you settings or come with settings. Where you by chance are removed. I'm not really expert on campaign mechanics, but if no, there are campaigns that give you units no matter what condition. But I think there are also campaigns that might strip you of units that got damaged. Which makes sense, you know, could be that they are battle worthy in the battle you commenced, but afterwards they simply did a damage assessment and said no, driving with this thing, commencing an offensive is not possible, sorry commander, whatever, we need to go back and maintenance it. And I assume stuff like this happens, and so we will go. So basically principle of commanding, adapt, survive and succeed. And make the best of out of what you're given without complaining too much. And despite this, I think we're doing pretty good. I got a feeling that first and second battle worked out in our favor. Casualties were low. And after this mission, we will definitely, after I figured out the, how to interpret the screen I shown last time, the campaign information visualization, we will receive full replenishment after this mission. So we might see our Panzer II's return and also the Panzer IV that is missing. But could be also that they are rerouted for other operations. Even if you have a Kampfgruppe, it doesn't mean that. And that there's still tasks like flank, support, flank, observation that might be happen off map. Especially the Germans always had little assets for much to do. And looks like that King Tiger ran out of fuel and was abandoned for the time being. We picked up the crew. Have fuel to spare, but we need to get it back, and I could imagine that the Americans might try to disable or to recover it. But Americans launched a massive attack from the east. das hier machen. Indicates that the force is large enough that it cannot be stopped, only delayed. Das kriegst du. Okay, interesting setup. So we need to retrieve something and then get away or something, GTFO out of the map. Fighting this role, not a last stand. Interesting mission setup. So we try to retrieve the vehicle and then fight. Delay and get out of there. I need to check the map again. Kintega is surrounded by a force consisting of infantry and several tanks. Battalion sized. Okay. Company of tanks. To reach you in 10 or 15 minutes. One platoon, the pioneers, and one panzer should be sufficient. Okay. Jesus, this will become really demanding. Okay, what? Ah, that's, yeah, okay, it's here, okay, I got it. That's our King Tiger. This thing we need to exit on the enemy side, which makes zero sense. Because the Americans have not had time to reinforce the town defense before you attack this anyway. Okay, so we have best conditions achieved. Yeah, give me the. Where's my Panther? Imagine they would have stripped us. What? Forward. What the heck? Is that a different setup zone or what? Where's the road not covered? God damn. Somebody forgot to cover the road. Yeah, whatever. Oh. Or is it on purpose? I don't know. Okay. One platoon. What was mentioned is enough, so we will stick with the recommendation. Because one platoon, the pioneers, and one panzer shopping. So, okay. Platoon. That's the engineer. A fifth platoon of the engineers. You can split up. You are in good shape. You will assist us. He isn't that far away. One platoon will cover. One platoon will basically always move. Okay. Doesn't he? Oh, damn it. This is really. I don't see that much. This will become difficult to defend. I mean, this is obvious. Good defense and moving down to this trench. But it's also difficult. If the enemy approach a trench and you are in this trench, it can become a quite battle with a lot of casualties. Enemy exit. Enemy exit, but not our exit. Yeah, light vehicles, I think they can move, they can get GTFO light from the beginning. I don't think we will have that much need for ammo. Or at least we need to watch out with the mortars in the woods. Sometimes mortars can fire when they are in woods. What is the... These two exits. We can deploy in the woods, okay. Yeah, I think I need some ammunition for the mortars, but Kübelwagen, you can go home immediately, basically. This is the mortar platoon. Not sure if I want to set them right in the open. I need to move them, perhaps. But yeah, the terrain is dry. Yeah, absolute new scenario for me. I really played a lot of campaigns, but this is puzzling for me right now. And keep two mortar, the more two, yeah, but okay, I need to keep them close enough because the only guy that has a radio. Wait, you have a radio, you have no radio. Yeah, the section commander and everybody else has no radio, the trucks aren't. Not sure, Kübelwagen, you are equipped with a radio? No. There are Kübelwagen, I think, that are equipped with radios, but not this one. Not sure, but we can't keep them. But in the woods, they should be somewhat safe. However, perhaps don't use this here, this is exposed. Use this part, this is behind a hedge. You still can do indirect fire without having the danger to being fired upon from early on. Just need to keep the mortars away from being in too dense wood, because it can impede on a line of fire. When you're in dense woods, it's simply too dangerous and unviable to fire mortars up. Because if I get... It might be... Here you get it, I mean, it's obvious. You might fire into some tree or whatever. Not sure if the vehicles really can move that good through this stuff. Even with dry conditions, they might get stuck. But, I mean, would you move a goddamn truck through the woods? Normally, you always do the reality check, there might be a good reason. I mean, this area is, yeah, come on, don't touch a running system. I don't want to move trucks, wheeled vehicles through woods. In reality, I wouldn't do it as well. This is absolutely hidden here, they can operate here, and everything will be fine. Everybody has his own ammo count, but everybody is in contact, can we call in every artillery? Yes. The gun is deployed here, I mean, might be a reason why he's deployed here. Could be a good position. What is with the main highway? Yeah, the main highway will be guarded by the King Tiger and by the Panther. There's also Panzer 4 in reserve. We might definitely need something on the flank. Let's say we retrieve it, refuel it quickly, and then we can have a King Tiger here, a Panther here, AT, and a Panzer 4 here. Would make sense. About this running around, I don't know. I mean, these are big hatches, so why not? I might leave everything like it is, except for splitting forces up. Yeah, this doesn't look really safe. Does it? Can we really retrieve from here when they come in full force? Could get absolutely cut off here. I don't like this. Yeah, impossible, but if you run back, could get picked off. But there might be a reason why he did this way, and I'm somewhat lazy. Is there a radio inside? No. I think this vehicle is not needed. Not planning on expending that much ammo that we will run out of ammo. What is this? I can't get the thing out of here. Because everybody is replenished. Everybody is having full ammo. No need to keep some Opels and Kübelwagens around here. Okay, second platoon maintain. Left flank will move out. Immediately capture the King Tiger. Do we want to split teams? This will result in what? Yeah, I mean, why not? Why not? Bazooka, bazooka, bazooka. Yeah, bazooka, can you hit the road from here? Let's get a position where you can hit the road. Ah, come on. Too much trees. But this here, come on. Against this you. Oh, what the heck is... But I think he sees it. Yeah, he will see it. This, the area target or target command is standardized, I think, to 1 meter above ground. A tank is higher, way higher than that, so it isn't giving you exact information about what would be possible to aim at. Yeah, this guys you can combine. There's no need to have, I don't know, one guy around and four guys around. You stay here. Do we have any vehicles that have some anti-tank weapons? This elements will move out. We have one. What is this? Yeah, it's a one platoon. Let's find a good approach. I think direct approach, sometimes direct is best. And like I mentioned, always one platoon moves, one platoon covers, engineers cover, and one tank on the right flank will simply move down quick fashion. The Panther will move down. Yeah, it's okay, it's okay. And... God. Yeah, this machine gun looks well situated. Same here. I will stick, I think, I really like it. I love Fang's campaign design of providing this. Sometimes can be nuisance, especially because the scenario, I learn a lot from this. Yeah, good idea with these guys here. Can I save a lot? Worst would be for me, you know, and others might love it, but worst would be for me, all forces here, and I need to redeploy them myself. I like to have inspiration and then drawing from this and thinking, okay, and doing some changes. Beautiful, exactly my thing. Because this makes the difference between setup of, which might take half an hour or 1 hour even, and taking some minutes. And you can also learn something, because many of these guys that make the campaigns, perhaps it comes with campaign making that you might understand the game better, especially when it comes to terrain, observation and whatever. Okay, engineers, that's our HQ elements. What is this thing here? Kübelwagen. I get the Kübelwagen out of here. Kübelwagen. Normally I show a best combat vehicle, but not today. Kampfgruppe Engel, Crack. Engel. Well, I will participate with these guys. We will move out. Let's capture this King Tiger. Where's the King Tiger crew? This guy's here, okay, join me. Elite, they're even better, man. Mutter, was? Mutterspech. Mutterspech, Geiger, what? Yeah. And Engel. Geiger, wait, Geiger is first platoon. That's me and Bauer. Jack Bauer. Engel, Geiger, Mutterspech, man, Comedy of Heroes. What is this here? Bush. Half track. Yeah, I mean, a half track can be. Only a driver inside. And I don't think I will deploy you. Wait, do you have something? Yeah, you have a Panzerfaust. Give me that Panzerfaust. I personally want to blast something off my deck. So, game is already stuttering, I guess the enemy already spawned. I personally will make sure that give me the Panzerfaust. 30k, that's a small one, right? 30k. I need to take myself a look. Wow, that's a big one. What was the number again implying? But 30 quarts. Quarts short. It's definitely not a little one. Yeah, it's a Panzerfaust Klein, and we can read the manual because this game is absolutely ridiculous. So, Kopf abnehmen. You need to remove the head. Kopf senkrecht halten und Zündladung. Zündregler, das dem Papier, das Deckblatt, yeah, something complicated with paper and whatever. I guess something that is removing the. Mentioning how this paper has to be aligned. Zünder einsetzen und mit dem Zündhütchen gegen das Papier ab. Deckblatt, okay, whatever. Kopf wieder aufsetzen. So, there's something with a primer inside. You need to remove it. Whatever, put something in and then I think this marker here has something to do, then put it on. Kopf wieder aufstecken. Die Pappkappe am Rohrende bleibt beim Abschuss aufgesetzt. Pappkappe am Ende, what? Pappkappe. Ah, this one. Feuerstrahl. So, you see combat mission, extremely educational. You can also learn by this game how to fire Panzerfaust from your, I don't know, Panzerfaust. The old Panzerfaust, not the new one, which is quite different. The modern one, Panzerfaust 3. For your next revolution attempt or whatever. 4, 5, 6. Yeah, wait. But if we split off, we have one anti-tank guy. That's... Can I split him off? Ah, damn it. And combine the squad? That's not possible. And what happens if I split off? If I do a normal split? I think I will get two solo guys and a four-man team. Because this indicates you always have teams. And it's not that better either. Yeah, I was believing that. But wait, if you get away and you stay with them, never tried this. Is this possible? Will they do a symbiosis? Yes. And then you can combine. Okay, you can combine a squad. But I'm happy with it. It will still occupy two squads. No, it doesn't. Beautiful. Because I want a Panzerschreck being alone. Yeah, normally it's not authentic. It's always two guys. But yeah. Because normally somebody else needs to reload from back, but it's okay. This guy is crack. He can reload fire and do everything on his own. Okay, yeah, come forward. You will join in the King Tiger operation. AT gun, yeah, fine. Do not engage infantry targets yet. Yeah, I know that's sometimes mentioned, but yeah, okay, we can do it, sure. I think I didn't see that much difference, and I hope there is not that much difference. Some people said, somebody mentioned that circular arcs might impact on attention towards the really important areas like the front line, but. I like to work with circular ones like this, and I don't know, I noticed that they still do their stuff as long as the facing is okay. Not okay, let's do it this one. Okay, are we ready for this defense? Yeah, the sniper, really, is this the best position you can come with? Yeah, absolute sniping position here. Oh wait, he can fire this. Yeah, okay. Didn't say anything. But your Kübelwagen... Sorry. The Kübelwagen ist ein Bild. Yeah, let's give this Kübelwagens. I mean, they don't need to drive away, and you never know, perhaps you need ammunition or a truck to charge to the enemy, so that's okay. Machine guns are fine, centered approach, perhaps it's better than a flanked tactic. Let's save. Wait, first order. We will rush that. First Zug, move out immediately. You know what? The pioneers will. Selected. Ah, okay. The pioneers will take base of fire immediately, so do not be afraid, we will immediately take positions. I myself will join the base of fire. Half tracks, Stummels. Yeah, but there, place a bit. Is this wanted? Not sure if we can really help. This way, perhaps. Every unit is in good position. This could be, of course, something that. Could. Or is it perhaps on purpose? Let's take a look. Can he? I can't see that good through. Okay. You can't tell me it's, if something comes by, I would have to fire in a split second. But this is still a worthy. It's still a worthy AT weapon. If we can find something where we can engage close range, which might be here. What the heck happened here? We are a bit exposed here. Don't overdo it. Can you aim through? Why is it so difficult? Yeah, that should be fine. Ah, come on. Yeah, exactly. Something comes forward, blast. Ah, I get it, okay. Yeah, it's. I still don't like it. Oh, this doesn't look. Natural, but I'm. Yes, this looks natural. Machine gun half track. There's only a driver, yeah, not needed. Exactly, it was the guy we retrieved the Panzer Force from. We can go home. There is a machine gun on top of it, sure, it is useful. But I don't know, the shielded machine guns, they get quite but behind hatches, yeah, hatch rows, not that stupid. Do we have some single man? Wait, there was a platoon that could strip off a single man, right? Who was this? This guy, yeah. G33 is still a good weapon. I mean, do I want to strip this guy off in order to get it on a machine gun? Yeah, come on. G33. I mean, G33 was often. Didn't have the best reputation. No, not sure why. It could be. It has something to do with the weapon being. In the later stage, they tried to simplify production as much as possible. Okay, so is this operational, this half track? Open up. Show me. I'm convinced. Yeah, behind a hedge, a machine gun half track can become quite convincing as well. Let's see, we have a center machine gun. I mean, everybody has a machine gun here, but except for this, that's a Stummel. Yeah, why not use this? Can you retreat? Ah, damn it, this is the only opening here. It's absolutely dangerous here, god damn it. So if they come after this hatch. Hey, come on, you can't tell me this is a shit position. If there would be opening here, it isn't. I could blast one with the engineers, yeah, let's do it. then it's fine. So I need to retreat like this. Stay behind the edges. Even here it will become difficult again. This is the hedges here. But it is fine again, you know, trees and everything. But this here is absolute dangerous if you need to retreat like this. With the vehicles at least. There is an opening here for the infantry, but the vehicles will be trapped. So yeah, let's get a protection for the Stummel here. Can you guys aim? Don't tell stories. What the heck is this fire zone? Ah, that's the exact place in front of a tree. I'm now happy. So not. Is this safe? There is a hedge cover. Okay, yeah, come on the flank. Beautiful. But I think you can't fight. Yeah, I suspected this. No, don't do stuff like this. Otherwise, he might notice you earlier. Yes! Yes, this is exactly what I'm looking for. Okay, and you blast. If there's an opening in the hedge, I'm not sure, does it even still require two? Whatever, we are not saving on. What? Press blast and. I'm interested, so. Experiment confirmed blast is in the setup zone, like move. Major discovery. Yeah, recons do not engage, you stay true to your role. Antigone's fine. Engineers, okay, yeah, I need a short break, didn't expect such moves. But yeah, and then we return to the operation Retrieve the King Tiger. See you.